Hey guys, welcome to creatingtracks.com, and today we're going to learn about Maschine, the software and the hardware a little bit. And this is the Maschine Studio that I'm using, but the software is Maschine 2. So when you open up Maschine, you see this window over here, and you can click this little icon on the right and drag this window. So on your hardware, this section on the bottom left is your transport window. That's your play, record, and everything. So here's the play, the record, erase, if you want to erase any sound on your pads. We have the restart, metronome, all these controls are here in the bottom left. And if you have the Maschine 2 or the Maschine Micro, your transport window might look a little different, but most of the rules are pretty much the same on the hardware. So right above the transport, we have the groups. So we have 8 groups, and each group gets 16 sounds of its own. So because right now I'm in group A, so I can get 16 sounds for group A, whichever ones I want. And then in group B, I can have 16 different sounds. And similarly, there are 8 groups, so C, D, E, F, G, H. So that's your group section right there, and each group gets 16 sounds of its own. And how you get these sounds is here in the browse option. So even on the software, if you click on these icons on the left, on the top left over here, that's what your browse will show up. So this is your Maschine sample library that comes with Maschine. And here I can select from projects, I can select groups, individual sounds, samples, instruments, and different kinds of sounds. So for now, we'll just go on groups. So, and you can click it with your mouse as well over here on the top left. So in groups, I can use the far right knob to scroll down and use these knobs to like go through my categories. So I can either scroll down for my hardware or use the mouse and scroll down like that. And here on the right side, on the second screen, is where you can select your kits or instruments or loop packs. But for now, I'm just going to go to the kits. And then in the kits, I'm going to select some different kind of kit with my second knob. So let's say digital kit, or I could even go drum synth. Let's go to urban kit. Urban kits are more like hip hop. So with the last knob, I'll scroll down and select a kit and then hit the top right button on the top section, which is the load button. So when I load it, you can see that the kit has been loaded with 16 different sounds, and there's a MIDI pattern that they've made for you so that you can hear what these sounds will sound like. And then you can click on this slider on the bottom and then click on the far right point and stretch that out so that you can zoom out and get a full view. So you can select all these notes and play them, and here's what it sounds like. All right, and now if I go to group B over here, I have 16 more sounds that I can pick. So I'll just go to groups again, and then maybe go to digital kit and pick any kind of different kit. And then I can hit this button, which is the load button, and then just load that. So here we have another pattern, and this is what it sounds like. So you can click these MIDI notes and move them around and edit this whole window, or you could just select the whole thing and delete it and then add your own MIDI notes. So that's basically what our browse menu does. It's the whole sample library that comes with Maschine or any other samples that you have on your computer. And you can go to like instruments, effects, sounds, and samples. So that's what you do in the browse menu. And now we have the sampling option. So if you click on this sampling, you can sample individual sounds on these pads. So if I have this sound or that sound, and then if I hit sampling, you can see the waveform. So if I select a different sound, you can see those specific waveforms. So here on the left screen, you have your start and end point where you can start or end the sample wherever you want. Okay, so you can also edit your clip over here, slice it. You have zones, and even on the right side, you can truncate it, fade in, fade out, just a bunch of effects that you can even see on your software on the bottom section over here. And all these buttons do a whole lot of different things. So if I select let's say reverse, I can hit apply and then it reverses my clip. All right, so I can fade in, fade out, cut, copy, paste, just do a whole bunch of different sampling effects for individual sounds. So now let's focus on this menu over here in the middle. So here we have our mute button, which is you can mute individual sounds, whichever ones you hold the mute button and you tap the sounds, they'll mute it. Then we have a solo where you can solo one sound and then everything else will get muted. And then we have the select button where you can select a sample if you're in a different effect and you can duplicate a sound. So if I want that sound into this key, then I can hit the duplicate key, select that, select the new key, and now both the keys are the same thing. And then we have navigate. So the top four are for the top screen and the bottom four are the bottom screen. So the up and down and left and right is zoom in, zoom out, and then slide left and slide right. So the bottom four are for the bottom screen and the top four are for the top screen. So that's going right, going left, and zooming out. And then pad mode is mostly used for instruments, but it's for placing a sound along a keyboard. So if I select a sound, and then I hit shift and pad mode, then it will give me that specific sound along a keyboard. So check it out. All right, and if I get out of pad mode, I'm back in the kit. All right, so, and then we have the pattern and the scene selection, and we'll talk about all of this in a lot more depth later on. So here in your software, this is where all your sounds are, and that's the most you need to know for now is there's the browse, and then there's the sampling, and then you have individual sounds where you can select and do a bunch of different sampling edits too. So explore all these options and check out all these buttons and just fiddle around with your software and your hardware. And we will cover all these topics in a lot more depth. So I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and definitely stay tuned for more. Until next week, peace.